Now, look, I'm not going to give up on the need for a royal commission into the pandemic response in this country. More doctors are now adding their weight to the push, dubbing the pandemic our worst ever public health failing. The Albanese Labor government, of course, is conducting only a narrow inquiry run by three hand-picked experts. And even the Australian Human Rights Commission says that's not good enough. Today, Dr. Scott Prasser from the Australian Institute for Progress took his case for a royal commission to a Senate committee hearing.
The reason why we've had a royal commission into the robo-debt crisis, as was promised by the Albanese opposition, but not a royal commission into the pandemic where 15 to 20,000 Australians possibly died, is because of politics.
Yeah, predictably though, the government has defended its own inquiry and just doesn't want a full royal commission unpicking all aspects of our pandemic response.
We want this to be a sober, expert process. We don't want it to be, you know, a witch hunt or a bit of a show that sort of rakes over every single one of the thousands and thousands and thousands of decisions. Otherwise, we just won't learn the lessons of the pandemic in the sober, evidence-based way that I think we need to.
Wow, there's some contorted logic there. Let's go to Liberal Senator for South Australia, Alex Antic. Alex, good to talk to you. How is it that we learn the lessons if we refuse to pick over all these decisions? It's an absolutely ridiculous bit of logic there from the Health Minister.
Yeah, look, it just doesn't make sense at all when you think about it, Chris. And we heard that today from this inquiry, from the Senate Legislation, Legal and Constitutional Affairs Committee, which heard all this great evidence, heard it from the Human Rights Commission, Commissioner Finlay and others, who made the observation that we have royal commissions and have had over the years for things like the HIH banking scenario, the UN Oil for Food program, and, you know, all the way through to any other number of different issues, all of which might be well meritorious in their own right. But if we've had anything more significant than COVID over the last generation, then I'd be surprised. And what is the logic behind not taking a root and branch approach to picking over this? I mean, so many people were affected. Everybody in the country was affected. We've got nurses that are still getting denied work. We heard stories today about nurses who are living, sleeping rough, living in their cars. The fallout from this is enormous. There were a lot of mistakes made across the board, across Australia, and there is really no excuse for not having a royal commission other than simply weaseling out of an election promise.